need a return ticket where you're going. This is a one-way journey.
Straight down!
Gamesmaster. I used to think all light entertainment shows were the same, but then again, I used to like records before I discovered CDs. Among the strangely shaped objects on tonight's show, we have our first challenge to be set by the Gamesmaster.
My first challenge is on the charming platform game Nicky Mania on the Mega Drive. Contestants have 1 minute to collect as many points as possible, taking care to avoid the many obstacles that block the little rodent's way. Good luck.
Moving on down for our first challenge, we have Tyra Hussein and Nora Quarty. Now, Tyra, you are super cool, and I'll tell you why. Because you've told us that you don't like green vegetables, which I think is very smart. What's your top five all-time worst green vegetables now?
Peas.
Very clever answer, and you didn't have to do so much thinking as well. Very clever, Tyra. You'll obviously go far. Nora, now, you said you want to be Linford Christie in another life.
Yes.
Yeah, did you see when he won the Commonwealth gold? Well, tell me the first word that sprung to mind when you saw his face.
He was a bit grumpy, and he just thought that he knew he was going to win.
Yeah. And we'll be checking your face carefully to see if you think the same tonight, Nora. While Nora and Tyra are preparing to play the challenge, let's find out what this week's news is. The latest high-tech movie eating box office pie in the States is Stargate. Using the old let's film in the desert and pretend it's an alien world trick, Stargate tells a story of army bloke and Egyptologist bloke who stumble through a portal into another dimension.
Stay right here and shoot anything that comes down that ramp.
Featuring the bloke who was a bird who was a bloke in The Crying Game, the film opens the cinemas next January.
My orders were simple. Track down signs of any possible danger. Well, I found some.
The game veteran from Acclaim follows soon after. A few weeks ago, we showed you the first three games for Sega's new 32X add-on. The next batch due after Christmas includes the rather bizarre beat-em-up Cosmic Carnage. Also, the ancient arcade classic Space Harrier, and yet another ancient arcade classic, Afterburner. All this looks funky, though some original titles would be nice. Go on, you know you want to. An exclusive test preview last week in Hamley's Metropolis Centre was the 75% complete Virtua Fighters 2. With new characters, more polygons and loads of extra moves, Virtua Fighters 2 already makes its predecessor look like, Virtua Fighters 1? That was news. Now it's time for Mickey's 65th anniversary challenge. Helping me along with this is Steve Merritt from Mean Machine. Steve, I can understand a 50th or 100th anniversary game, but why a 65th?
Well, Mickey is now of pensionable age, and they had to get in before Mickey's Magic Bus Pass came out.
And of course, Mickey can now qualify to stand in front of shop queues all over the world.
Absolutely. He can probably queue for free vegetables too.
Now, Steve, any tips? Have you got any tips for our two contestants here?
Yeah, you have to take it a bit easy. I mean, there's a lot of stuff to collect, but there's a lot of hazards too. There's swinging maces. There are cranes which have to lift up to higher levels, and there's loads of hidden masties in crates and things. So just take it a bit easy.
Okay, the challenge is each contestant gets 1 minute to collect as many of Mickey's magical anniversary pellets as they possibly can. Tyra is going first. Best of luck. Your 1 minute starts now. And off goes Tyra. In the top right hand corner of the screen, you can see how many pellets that she has. There's a star there, Steve. So
it's a lot more pellets, and she's a bit silly to miss it because there isn't a lot for quite a while. She's going to have to get across the line and jump up onto the parrot's back.
She got hit.
She missed the parrot.
How many hits can she take before she's...
It depends. I should imagine Mickey's on his last legs. That rocket was a restart point, but unfortunately that won't come into play because you only get one attempt.
Okay, 25 seconds gone.
She's got to land on the window ledge. She's missing the window ledge.
Oh, no.
She
that, which is a terrible way to go, which means that Tyra's challenge is over. Can she make way for Nora? Okay, Nora, best of luck. You've got to beat 13 pellets. Your 1 minute starts now. Okay, off Nora goes once again. The number of pellets on the top round
comes. She never wants to be linked for Christie. Now's the time to run, like, she got the start. That was a really, really good start. And she must avoid the parrots and make sure she gets on the ledges.
But she hasn't been right yet.
On the chance.
15 seconds got a quarter way through the time. It's up on Nora. Oh, took one hit there. Oh,
she's got to spring out.
Now, she might have the same problem as Tyra did. Is she going to get to this ledge?
She went straight through it.
It's a very transparent ledge. That's a bad woodwork there, I reckon. Halfway through the time, she's level on
score. She's on the ledge.
One more pedal, that's it. And Nora dies after she gets 14, but that's enough because she's the winner.
Well done, Nora.
Bad luck, Tyra. Perhaps if you'd eaten your greens, you might have gone that little bit better.
Maybe.
But you're still not going to have any peas.
No.
Okay, I admire your principles, I have to say. Nora, that was very, very close, wasn't it? Was there any stage where you didn't think you were going to do it?
Yeah, when it came to when you spring up into the ledge.
So it's quite tricky, that, but you were looking a bit Linford Christie grumpy there for a while, were you?
Yeah.
But you're not grumpy now, Nora, because you have won the Gamesmaster Golden Joystick. Of the series, we've seen many pieces of plastic, good and bad. But enough about our reviewers, let's find out what games they're looking at.
First up, upset parents everywhere by shooting more real-life digitized actors in Lethal Enforcers 2.
For all budding cowboys out there, you can now get your hands on Lethal Enforcers 2. Basically, you can take part in armed robberies, bank robberies, shoot 'em ups at the saloon, and even the Wild West chase with the Indians.
The gameplay is very, very straightforward. Basically, shoot all the bad guys. They're very obvious. They wear black hats and stuff. And try not to shoot the pretty cowgirls and the nice old men.
It's a great game. Somehow this kind of gameplay works really well, although it's not a long-lasting one. Once you've shot all the people you can shoot, then you're never going to come back to it.
Next up, the most gorgeous looking thing since Melissa from 30-something, Magic Carpet.
If I was to say that Magic Carpet was doom in the air, I'd actually be lying, but it's somewhere near the truth. You're floating around in a 3D environment, you've got to collect mana so you can build up a huge castle, and you get some wonderful spells at your disposal. Most notable of which is, of course, the earthquake, which tears its way through the landscape and wonderful 3D graphics.
Shoot lots of things, rescue lots of people, increase your magical power, and take over magical Arabian kingdoms. It's a good-looking game, but again, it's only going to appeal to a limited audience since you need a super powerful machine to get the most from it.
Finally, flying Desert Strike type 3D polygons ahoy in Z-Wolf.
It's a sort of helicopter shoot-em-up, a bit like Desert Strike, but much more 3D. You can travel around the whole area instead of just sort of an isometric view. The graphics aren't up to all that much. I mean, it looks a bit like Virus from about 10 years ago, but happily, the gameplay is amazing.
This isn't your average everyday shoot-em-up. It's not one where you can just sit down, get straight into it, and go around blasting things. There's a lot of artillery, a lot of armor you have to take care of before you can get down to the actual business of rescuing hostages.
You have to scour the earth, destroying entire battalions of tanks, planes, and artillery. It takes a long time to complete this game. We're about a third of the way into it, and it's huge. And there's nothing particularly new on offer here, but it's such a solid and playable package, I think Amiga owners will love it.
Right, while we peel the young girls off of tonight's special guests, let's go over to Gamesmaster and find out what their challenge is.
I have something a little different for you now. We get all musical on the video puzzle game VidGrid on the PC. I've selected two of my favourite videos, November Rain by Guns N' Roses, and Give It Away by the Red Hot Chili Peppers, and Scramble Them. Contestants have a total of 2 minutes to unscramble both videos if they're going to earn my golden joystick.
Now, it's time for a walk down Teen Sensation Road as we welcome Lee, Richie and Rob. Let loose! To be a teen pop sensation.
Right.
So tell me how you do it. Lee, start me off. Step one.
Tell you what you do. Show a lot of body, comb your hair, brush your teeth, that sort of thing. Yeah. Okay. Don't write any songs, that kind of thing.
All right. Step two.
Oh, cheers. I was going to say that. I think you should write songs, but thank you very much.
I think you should go to church on Thursdays.
I think you should.
That's what you should do. Not just Sundays, but Thursdays.
You should appear on Gamesmaster, and you know when you've been on Gamesmaster, you've made it.
Well, I have a problem in that I can't sing, I can't dance, I can't play an instrument, and I'm not terribly bright, so I guess it's East 17 then, for me. Right, while I go off and cut my first single then, we'll take a quick break. Welcome back. Our guests tonight are Let Loose, and before the break they told me how to become a teen pop sensation. Now we're going to see what their games playing skills are like. Brad Burton from Amiga Action is helping me describe the action. Brad, this is a variation on the old sliding puzzles that used to really annoy you when we were younger. What tips can you give Let Loose?
Well, I reckon what we could do here, Dominic, we could go with going for the corners, go for the old bingo method, get the corners in there and then we'll go for it then.
All right, best of luck, guys. They have 2 minutes in which to complete two videos. Best of luck, lads. Your time starts now. So off we go, November Rain by Guns N' Roses, and I think this video is what you call pretentiously arty. They've gone for a blue hue, which is tragically unhip. 9 seconds gone, they've got a couple of squares in place, that's not too bad. It's Lee who's doing the honours so far. That's the third square in place, not a bad start, Brad.
Yeah, well, they've got to go and get the corners in done.
Okay, that's right, as you said, start for the corners in the bingo. There was a bearded Frank Zappa looking like conducting there, and just about, yes, they've got all four in the bottom left-hand corner, but they look a bit out of place, Brad.
Yeah, that's right, come on, go for it.
Yeah, I think you've been go for it in the top right-hand corner. The one with those four squares up there, Brad, then they'll be sorted, yeah?
That's right, Tom.
Okay, then, we've had about 40 seconds gone, and he's making a bit of a hash-up of it now, Lee. Actually, he started off so well, but he's a bit thick now, actually, Lee. Unfortunately, he's probably the best-looking one out of the three Let Loosers, but in the brains department, he's falling seriously short tonight. We're coming up for nearly 1 minute gone up. Again, although we got a couple in the middle there, but Brad, terrible, yes?
That's terrible, Dom, terrible!
Okay, we've got 56 seconds left, and they're not getting any closer at all now. This is an embarrassment for Let Loose. They can console themselves with a single sense, but that's about it. And in fact, Lee has done the honest thing and given way to Richie, the lead singer. Now, can Richie do any better? He's got 42 seconds left, and they've got more minutes after this to do as well. It's all a mess, but they've got one or two in the corners now, Brad.
Oh, I think it's worse when it started.
I think you may be right, actually, Brad. We've got... This looks a bit nice now. A little bit of Axel singing at the piano. We've got three sort of corners. Oh, look at this.
Oh, just so I want to have a Christmas song.
I'm sure you are, Brad. This is nearly it. In fact, yes, they've done it. They've done the Guns N' Roses ones, but they've only got 19 seconds left to sort out the Red Hot Chili Peppers videos. It's an impossible task, but off they go anyway. Chili Peppers, give it away. They've only got 16 seconds to do this, and can they do it, Brad?
Not a chance, Tom.
No, I didn't think. They've got 12 seconds left, and Rob is doing it now, and he's not doing any better, actually. 6 seconds left. Oh, they're all in this unofficially. Think. 4, 3, 2, 1. You've got 5 minutes in place. Time is out, which means that Let Loose's challenge has ended in failure. Give a round of applause.
Oh, dear. Bad luck, guys.
Bad luck, Richie. Bad luck, Rob.
Okay, first of all, now, Lee, what didn't go terribly well at the start. Talk us through it. What was happening?
Well, I mean, to be honest, you know, we are basically rubbish. I think that probably sums it up. No, I mean, the first one wasn't too bad. You know, we managed to get the middle line okay, but then it sort of went horribly wrong.
Yeah. And I don't know whether it's just because you're the singer or not, Richie, but I think you were hogging it a bit much, actually, towards the middle.
No, I gave Rob a go at the end. To be honest, I couldn't even see the television set. I couldn't see the arrow properly, honestly, so I had to give it to Rob.
And Rob, but they only gave you a piffling 19 seconds.
Well, that's what I expected from these two. I didn't expect any more than that. I was actually pleased to get 19 seconds. Normally it's 9 seconds.
Yeah, I think they would have done better, actually, if they'd given you a bit.
We've got a few of those on the Chili Peppers, you know.
I know. Well, it's a sad day, guys, actually, because I'd say cancel that next single release because of that poor performance. Let loose, go into the cage. No. And while we mourn the sad loss of another teen pop sensation, let's cheer ourselves up with the consultation zone.
It's time for me to suffer another bunch of lost souls with terrible afflictions to enter my consultation zone. Unfortunately, I can only solve their game-playing deficiencies. But who's first?
Gamesmaster. I like Benefactor on the Amiga, but I can't get off the bungee jump without dying.
What you need is a friend. Pick up the first merryman and run to the right. Let him go down the ladder and head toward a small gap. Then jump off the top ledge onto the bungee jump, collecting the keys as you fall. At the bottom, our little friend will make a small bridge appear under your feet, allowing you to jump off the rope safely.
Thanks, Gamesmaster, that's great.
Bring on another.
All my friends get angry at me because I take too long to choose my character when I'm playing Mortal Kombat 2. Can you help me?
Well, try this. While you're on the character select screen, move the cursor onto Liu Kang. Then press up and start together. A character will automatically be selected for you. Try to be a little less spineless in future. Any other simple ones?
Hey, big guy. When I'm playing Banshee on the Amiga, I get really annoyed by the polar bears. There must be a way I can liven them up.
This one's easy. On the high score table, type the following reprehensible code. I am exquisitely evil. This way into you in the Kill the Polar Bear mode, where you'll be able to put a grisly end to his cuddly capers.
Thanks, Gamesmaster.
That's enough wisdom for one session. I'll be back soon. See you anon.
A typical two-up, two-down in small-town America, home to an equally cheesy American family, the Lincolns, Mom, Dad, and Son Jeffrey. Hello, Mum.
Hi, honey.
But Jeffrey isn't that ordinary. For 40 grand, he'll throw a football match. He's also a fully paid-up citizen of the Imagination Network. INN, as it's known, is a virtual town where people from all across America can meet up on their PC screens and take part in over 80 different activities. You can put on bad clothes and get golfed up, play some boring cards, enter a medieval fantasy adventure, or just hang around and talk pants.
I've made about probably 100 friends on INN. All of them come from the United States, some from California, all the way down to New York.
And they all think you're groovy.
Jeffrey, dinner's ready.
Not content with meeting virtually, members regularly meet up at INN conventions. If you think they should be locked up by the fashion police, that's because they're dressed as their network personas or toons. This is how Jeffrey appears to other people on the network. If you're going to make lots of friends, then you need an interesting toon and a handle, which is a name to you and me, that conveys something about you.
I chose my handle because I think it shows. It says that I'm a. I have a good eye for shooting people down in Red Baron.
Jerk.
Jeffrey, dinner's ready, honey.
Yeah, and
it's my local hangout.
Exactly, yeah, it's like a bar in here. I spend more time sometimes on INN than I do going out socially.
Oh, I know, I do.
And to think Americans have nuclear weapons. Like any other town, INN is expanding daily with more services coming online.
Jeff, what are you doing in there?
Poor Mrs. Lincoln, it seems little Jeffy's discovered many blokes and birds more interesting than his gorgeous mum.
It's almost time for us to bathe in the end of show waters. Before we splash around, though, let's go over to Gamesmaster for the final challenge.
My final challenge for the show is on the PC Monster Fest Creature Shock. Our challenger has to dispatch two hideous critters before they turn him into a light snack, taking care to hit them where it hurts. Good luck.
Now, please welcome our final challenger on this fine day, Mark Brazier.
You had a bit of an unpleasant experience a couple of birthdays ago, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. Well, it's a couple of bouncers that I used to work with at a certain place. They decided it'd be very funny to strip me naked and give my clothes to somebody else. So I had to go and get them, really, and it's a bit embarrassing, you know.
Which was actually the original challenge we were going to be doing tonight.
Was it?
But then we had to change it to Creature Shock. All right, listen, best of luck, Mark, if you'd like to take your place on the Games Playing Rock, and we'll go up to the commentary box. Joining me for Creature Shock is Joss Dawson from Portal. Joss, do you have any humorous birthday anecdotes?
Yeah, quite another similar one, actually. A couple of years ago, my 21st, I was celebrating that what I thought was a quiet drink with a couple of friends. Mm. Ended up with me stripped to my boxer shorts, handcuffed to a lamppost, left me there for an hour and a half in the freezing cold.
But you actually asked them to do that, no?
Paid them, yeah, but
right.
Didn't expect them to do it.
Joss, have you got any tips for Mark on this, then?
Right, yeah, it's a tough game. Brilliant-looking game. But the key to it is that when the monsters attack you, you haven't got any defence, so you have to keep pummeling them, have to keep on firing, and you'll be all right.
Okay, best of luck there, Mark. Mark has to defeat two monsters in this to get the joystick. Off you go. Okay, of course, Mark, he's just got through a little cave just now. He's just about to get one of the monsters. At the bottom of the screen, you can see a little man, bottom right-hand corner with a figure. That's his energy. Two slots above that, you've got a wibbly wobbly thing at 100%. That's going to be the energy of the monster he's facing. Here is the first one. It's a kind of grey mutant spider-like thing, Joss.
Yeah, it looks like some kind of one of those funny petrified fish. The trick he's got to do, you see the green area?
No, but that thing
the green area on the belly of the monster. He's got to hit that. That's how he scores the points.
Is that the only weak spot?
That is his Achilles heel.
Right.
As you can see, the monster's score is going down. His health is
25, actually. He's been brilliantly on this so far, Mark. His energy's 90, so he's hardly taking a hit, Joss. He's following your advice.
He's doing very well indeed. He's getting in there. He's got to finish him off now.
You can see the screen flashes every time the spider guy gets him. He's gone into 84% now. 81 now. Not quite so good now. He's losing it a bit.
Just got to be a little more accurate.
Oh,
and he's
that's
turned
it.
Well.
Beautiful shot there. The spider gets it. Blows up in a puff of green. And now we're on to the second monster. Just a little trip through these little caves here. Marginally more interesting than walking through the mountain greens.
Gotta watch out for the bird.
You got a little bug.
That's not actually the second monster that just gets in the way. It's just there to annoy you.
It's just been there to annoy you. It's sort of a Kelly Christian of this game.
There he is.
And it's, oh no, it's on his face.
His head, no, he's got rid of it.
And it flies off.
Chickened off, quite literally.
Okay, his energy 71% just now. Is that going to be enough to defeat this?
That's okay. He's only got one more monster to defeat. I'm admittedly, it's a bit harder, this second one. But he's doing all right. That's a good score.
Okay.
Gotta locate the monster first in the pool. Here he is.
So here comes the second monster. It's in the pool, and he's a very attractive looking one. This one, Joss, isn't he?
There's some sort of octopus arrangement here. What he's got to do now is shoot him in the eyes. Just the black ends
the
of
black
his eyes.
The black bits on the sides there.
That's where we score the points.
Okay, the monster's down to 12, actually.
He's doing very, very well.
Mark's down to 15. See that monster, Joss? That's your girlfriend, that is.
Thank you very much,
Dominic. Oh, it's gone! Joss's girlfriend bites the dust.
I'm
down
sorry.
To zero. Challenge!
Well, Mark, excellent. Now, I seem pretty straightforward.
But Mark, any bits you were troubled by at all?
Well, that first one, he kept covering up a bit, but, you know, soon got him.
And then the bat flew in your face?
Oh, yeah.
That was a bit tricky. What was going through your mind when that bat smacked you?
Well, it reminded me of your old hairstyle.
Ouch! You mean you don't like my Gary Barlow one?
Well...
This means I can go off and form a team band and all the others will be better looking than me, but I'll be the only one who can sing, play an instrument or write songs.
Oh, you sing then?
It's very good. Well, while four incredibly good-looking but talentless blokes get on the phone with suggestions for me, let's present Mark with the Gamesmaster Gordon Joystick. For now, I'm off to tell kids at Disneyland that Mickey Mouse is just a bloke in a suit. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.